Good job. Wow.
The basic tools which are used for direct marketing are contacting the customers using emails, online advertisement, through phone calls, and through magazine advertisements. And there are many other steps which are followed in the direct marketing. And the major steps which are followed while doing direct marketing are a company strategizes its decision to how to go for a direct marketing. And second step is choosing the mode of communication through which they are going to offer for the customers. Third step involves customer responses and orderings by responding to the direct marketing tools. And fourth step include fulfillment of the customer's wants or the orders which are received. And the fifth step include the database maintenance so that they can record how many of the responses they have received from the responses they have received. Okay, and the further slide about direct marketing, forms of direct marketing will be continued by my teammate. Thank you.
Fantastic. There are 11 members in your team. I hope the people, who have not spoken much will be getting an opportunity to speak. All the best. Go ahead. Beautiful.
Good evening, sir and batchmates. I'm Sanil Akawat. I'm here to discuss about forms of direct marketing. The direct marketing, the forms are direct selling. One of the form is direct selling. Here the selling of products is directly to the customer that they are away from the fixed retail location. And coming to the telemarketing, the telemarketing is the process of using the telephone to generate leads and also make sales or gather market information. And email marketing, it is sending a commercial message typically to a group of people, and every email is sent to a potential customer. And coming to the broadcast faxing, it is the oldest method of marketing, and also it's a fast and easy method of marketing for companies and products or services. And coming to the direct. Coming to the direct advertising, it is the strategy aimed at reaching consumers without the need of some type of intermediary to establish that connection. And also the coming to the direct mail, it is the marketing material or the product mailed directly to the homes of the customers or the consumers. And the couponing, as everybody is knowing, well aware of that, it is the marketing strategy that takes advantage of customers or consumers interested in saving money on a particular purchase or presenting products to consumers for less than the regular cost. That here they are impacting their satisfaction in lesser prices.
Yeah.
So these are the forms of marketing. Further presentation will be continued by our batchmates.
Good job, Sanja. Very good job. Thank you very much.
Advantage and disadvantage. Like every coin
I
has.
Shamima Parveen speaking here. Yes, you are a brand. Please.
Like every coin has two faces, direct marketing is also having both advantage and disadvantages. The advantages are it allows for the collection of relevant data and the customers. This is one of the main advantage in the direct marketing. And there is a possibility of greater accuracy in targeting consumers. And the timing can be controlled to maximize impact in direct marketing. And all the outcomes are precisely measurable in direct marketing, and it also provides more opportunity for feedback from customers. Since we are marketing directly, we get the opportunity and advantages to get all into the direct marketing. And the disadvantage in direct marketing is it has higher initial cost than traditional advertising. The initial cost is too high in direct marketing, and the spamming is also the possibility of spamming is also high in direct yes. marketing. That is, too many catalogs, junk mail and spams, etc. will occur in direct marketing. And there is a limited reachability. Since we are targeting the customers in through directly, so the reach will be also limited
yes.
and the less believably in eyes of consumer. Since we are advertising through directly, the customer, there is a possibility the customer have less belief on us.
True.
The next True. Slide will be continued by my batchmates.
Thank you, Shamima.
Good evening, sir and batchmates. I'm Shayok Chakraborty and I'm going to present the direct marketing process. So the direct marketing process is divided into broadly into 6 steps. The first step is set goals and objectives. Here we have to set our goals, like what kind of product to whom we are going to target and going to sell that things. And the next step is identifying audience and target. After segmentation, positioning and targeting is very much important, because in the case of direct marketing, the target audience is the main main stakeholders. The next step is choosing the delivery channel. So we have already seen in our marketing class that delivery channel is a very important thing, and we have a marketing debate also on this, like the delivery channel and the product management. So next, for direct marketing, we have to choose the proper delivery channel through which we can target our identified customer segment or customer group. The next step is selecting the types of responses. So for the responses, next step after choosing a delivery channel, we have to identify the responses from our target audience and position our brand according to the response. And next, execute the promotion. In case of direct marketing, promotion plays a very major role, like telemarketing and all are the means of promotion. Next, after that, we have to review our process and to analyze our result and continue the process. So okay. This is all about direct marketing process. And the next slide will be continued by Sayuja.
Good job, Sayak. Thank you. Great job.
Thank you, sir.
Team, move faster.
Yes, sir. So I'll just quickly summarize this.
Please.
Sir, this have been covered previously, but let's do a bit deep diving into this. These are the tools of direct marketing, and which is direct mail, which you receive directly on your emails. When you usually when you buy somewhere, you get a means you are registered as a customer there,
yes.
And they will give you mails, regular information. And then there are catalogs. Whenever you go through Amazon or Flipkart, you get the catalog, means the range of product that is available there. So that is the catalog what we talk about. Then there's telemarketing, where you are going to get phone calls informing you about the offers and everything
yes.
that is there. Then there is direct response advertising, which is actually where the company expects you to directly respond to their advertisement, means somewhere you will see, usually this happens in online mode, usually you will see that company are asking you to log in directly first before you buy, like Amazon and Flipkart does. You have to log in before you buy.
Mm-hmm.
So these are kind of things that they directly want a response from your side. And then there's integrated direct marketing, which is actually integration of all the channels, all the things, so that which costs less actually. This saves cost, and this will be further explained in the next slides. Thank you.
Good job. Thank you, Sahija.
Good evening, sir and batchmates. I am Sahija Budhi here explaining direct mail marketing. And
Lovely.
Examples of direct mail marketing are postcards, coupons, special offers, free newspapers, and it can also be say as advertising mail. Direct mail has the advantage of you will get the direct response from our customers, and email marketing is the very popular offshoot of direct mail marketing. Next slide, sir.
Wow.
And this is the direct mail message model. there are six steps to which through which we can achieve the success in direct mail marketing. It first starts with the attention, that gaining attention among the customers. Then personalization, then leading in means praising the customer with quotes and the offer you are giving. And fifth one is the letter, which through which the customer getting benefited. And the sixth one is closing. Lovely. Next slides will be presented by our batchmates. Thank you, sir.
Wow. Move faster. Great job, but move faster.
Then catalog marketing. In direct marketing, the catalog plays a major role. Like, it is the marketing through printed or a digital catalog mode, which is to be distributed by mail or in store. Then it is also a direct mail publication, which is showing a lot of merchandise. It become very popular and people are ready to pay for it, because many of the advertisers are focusing on video catalogs because it provides more information about the product, and the consumer also prefer to go on the online to review different catalogs of the different companies. They also vary from they include purses, rings, and all type of accessories in their catalog. They even go for electronic catalog for the readers with computer magazine. In this way, the catalog marketing is proceeding in direct marketing. Next slide will be continued by my teammate.
Whoa.
So telemarketing means it is, I'm Sharad Patel. Telemarketing, it is a marketing strategy in which marketing is done through telephones or emails or web-based video conferencing systems. Typical telemarketing campaign involves around 75 people making 250,000 calls over 3 months. That amounts to 40 to 50 customers per day. And these callers are from the call centers. And cold calling means it is the calling to random people among the customer base. So this is the most effective way of distributing the this is an effective way of telemarketing.
Okay.
And the message should be it should be simple, it should be understandable. And in case of technical details, use direct mails, because technical details are very tough to understand through telephones or web-based conferences.
Yes.
And it must be compelling, not boring. And it should have strong initial benefits. If the marketing involves too many processes or too many initial steps to registration, or some fill registrations or some processes, it will decrease the interest of the customers. And it must be short to tell enough through a telephone or a web-based video conferencing.
Okay, great job. Thank you, team 5.
Thank you, Sharad. Next slide. Thank you, Sharad. I am Pratik Shinde. Direct response marketing. In the direct response marketing is one of the way to engage our target audience. In this marketing, the instant response by they encourage customers by taking the specific action. In this, the marketers can leverage direct response by the many number of channels, such as the TV, print media, the radio, email, digital, social. The each direct response campaign should have the specific goals, such as a sign up, share with the contact, or register, etc. This marketing has some characteristics, like it is designed to get the immediate response or immediate action from the target audience. Then second is the move to the action makes it effective. Third is a traceable, that means who is responding to the ad or which media is responding. We get the whole details about it. Then fourth is a measurable, that means you can know the about the which ad is responsible for the sale of the company and how many sales are generated.
Yes.
And last is it can't be reach large audience, and reaching each individual will increase the cost for the company. Yeah. Thank you.
Lovely.
Good evening, sir and batchmates. I am Sindhuja, and I will be explaining about print media.
print media or traditional mass media published on paper. The concept not only includes the published products, but also regards the organizational context, shaping the journalistic routines and norms behind the printed products. Printed media represents the oldest and most widespread type of the mass media because, as opposed to electronic media, it does not require an elaborate technical infrastructure on the part of the user. It mainly comprises of newspapers and magazines. Newspapers are clearly associated with information and show an emphasis on the political issues and current events. They are valued as backbone of democratic public sphere because they enable comprehensive public discourse. News magazines also serve as important function, whereas most other magazines are more committed to entertainment and leisure. These magazines show a diverse spectrum ranging from lifestyle to special interest magazines. Whereas television is the good medium for direct marketers to advertise broadly.
Okay. Thank you, Sindhujam. Thank you very much. So this is the final slide.
Good evening, everyone. My name is Shubham, and my topic is what is integrated direct marketing. So basically, it's a type of attention grabbing, response generating, and increasing the awareness of the people, which may use multiple ways or channels to communicate to the target audience. So integrated direct marketing was first created in 1983. So let's see what are the different steps that are involved in that. So the first process is similar to any other marketing process, and it is the understanding of customer requirement. Second step in that is the involving the integration process, where all the available channel and resources are assimilated, so that it can be delivered the masses can be delivered to the target customer. Third step is to build upon the integrated marketing channel to provide significant service to customers. And the fourth step is the repetition of the EVA process, means of the third process. And fifth step, the last step, is to take the feedback from the service provider and sales executive to improve upon the services.
Phenomenal. Thank you so much. That's super.
Thank you.
Team 5, that's a great...
Awesome Team 5, sir.
Awesome. Great team effort. Could see, you know, almost 10, 11, every member from the team spoke. It looks like everyone from the team. I appreciate that everyone, more or less everyone, came onto the screen and presented so beautifully. You know, there are, of course, very picturesque and beautiful diagrammatic representation of the content. Beautiful content. Well done, job. Congratulations to Team 5. Team 5, direct marketing. Oh my God, that is nowadays, you know, it's there for quite some time. It's there for decades. Direct marketing is there, but of late, you know, because you look at the channels, you know, when you have 30 to 50%, sometimes, you know, that much of the selling price goes distributed for the intermediaries. So what you're trying to do is, you're trying to bypass all this, going to directly to the end user, direct marketing. So you can cut down on all these costs here. You cut down on all these costs and you share that benefit with the customer. You try to convince the customer, say, I'm coming directly to you. I'm not going through the channel. So all that, whatever I'm doing, I'm passing on that benefit to you. If I go through this, you know, then you will have to pay a lot. So you don't have to pay sort of stuff. You know, they are trying to do something. They're trying to either, they want to enjoy more profit, or they want to give some part of the benefit to the customer. That's how the direct marketing is catching up. So fantastic. That's a good job done. Let's give a big round of applause to Team 5. Can I hear some claps? Claps, please. Yeah, that's right. That's a good job. Thank you. Yeah, we need to appreciate